Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1815. Within plus or minus one of a target is a hit, otherwise a miss. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Today's question sent in a comment on YouTube for my episode 769. Is there any way an if statement can be checked for data plus or minus one of a value? So if it's greater than one and less than minus one, it'll say hit, and if not, it should say miss. Can you do this using the if statement? Now, this is a great example of there's so many different ways to solve this formula in Excel. And when I initially wrote it, I actually tried to follow the suggestions of the comment here with equal if, and then immediately launch into the and function where we test for both things. So the first test is the goal minus actual less than or equal to 1. That's the first test. And then the second test is goal minus actual greater than or equal to minus 1. If both of those are true, then we're within 1 and we say hit. Otherwise, we say miss. Now, this is backwards from what we have here. They're saying if it's greater than 1 and less than minus 1, then say hit. I think that's reversed. But if I'm wrong, if I don't understand the point here, then reverse the miss and the hit there. Press enter and double click to shoot that down. Now, the frustrating thing here is we have to do the A2 minus B2 twice. I'm going to go into the next worksheet. One choice is to do the A2 minus B2 in an extra helper column. That will shorten this formula over here. So equal if and either this is less than or equal to 1 or it's greater than or equal to minus 1. If both of those are true, then hit, otherwise miss. And so I answered these types of formulas in the comment at YouTube. I said, well, wait, we can simplify this greatly by using the absolute value function. Absolute value. So if we look at this difference, there's going to be positive numbers, there's going to be negative numbers, it's all over the board. But if we take the absolute value of that number, so ABS, it takes the number and changes it to the distance from 0 in a positive number. So if it was negative, it turns positive. This tells us how far we were from the actual, but it doesn't tell us whether we were greater than or equal to. This simplifies the if statement then. It's equal if this is less than or equal to 1, then we were close. Otherwise, it was a miss. All right, and finally, we can simplify that formula without the helper column. Equal if the absolute value of this minus this is less than or equal to 1, then hit, otherwise miss. And copy those down. All right, so four different Excel formulas that achieve the same outcome. Hey, if you like these formulas, check out my new laminated tip card. Two pages, lots of different formula tips and tricks right along the lines of this at tinyurl.com/Excel4, F-O-R. We'll take you out to the Mr. Excel Excel store where we have this tip card and seven other new tip cards, charting, VLOOKUP, pivot tables, Excel 2010, Excel 2013, and even macros to VBA out there. Oh, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.